Argentinië. Dus.
Also, I don't know if maybe because that's also something that's just a couple of days old. If you go to the map where we had the link to Google Maps, there on the top right of that map, there's now a link called Earth, and that actually does link it to Google Earth rather than Google Maps. So that's the first start of adding that functionality. And maybe Anne or Ari, who was posting that, hadn't seen that yet, and that maybe because of the question. Oh, okay, so it is Ari, I guess. So Ari, have a look at it, and maybe, I don't know, because it's fairly new, maybe you hadn't seen it yet, or you'd still like some more functionality. And if you do, or not just Ari, anybody, just drop us an email anywhere on wildearth.tv, finalcontrol@wildearth.tv, or directly to me, Pete, P-E-T-E, @wildearth.tv. And then any suggestions we'll definitely consider and see if we can add that as functionality. Yeah, sometimes the animals get annoyed with the birds, I guess. It's but that's another thing. We always think about the symbiosis and the mutualism that the birds get the food from the giraffe on the bird side. But from the way it looks now, it also they save energy by not having to fly and just taking a ride there. I don't think that's the main thing, but it might help a little bit. Well, as it looks now that the giraffe is walking off. Let me show, because this morning after the drive started, there were some hooded vultures at the waterhole, which I asked Peter to quickly interrupt this drive, because that is actually a very special sighting. Only, I think yesterday or the day before was the first time we ever saw, or at least I ever saw hooded vultures, or any vultures at the waterhole. So I wanted to show you that. Shortly afterwards, another animal popped up, which is also a quite nice sighting, but I didn't want to interrupt the drive again, so I decided I'd try to record it and see if I could show it to you during... Actually, what I'll do is I won't play it completely full screen, so that in the top you can see it's done through a media player. And that is the reason for that I'm doing that is that we pride ourselves on being live and always being honest about not what's not live. If I put it full screen and people would come into the chat, they might think that the hyena is actually there at the moment. If I leave the little controls for the media player on, it's clear that it's a recording. So that's actually why I'm not putting it full screen, because we always want to be upfront about and clear about what is live and what is not live. Me talking is live, but the hyena was there earlier this morning at around 6:15. So I'm just going to see if I can switch to that now. Let me just quickly think how to do that, because the mixing desk is still a bit off. Let me see, that should work hopefully. Let me just press the button and see what comes out. No, that didn't work for some reason. Okay, let me just switch back to the waterhole. I'll give the mic to Simon a little bit, because that's strange, that should have come up. I'll just quickly check what the setup is, and then I'll show you in a minute.
Okay, yep. And once again, this is Simon here at the Final Control. Yeah, you're watching WeChat with Pete Brott and myself, Simon Dills. And yeah, it looks like some more people are just joining into the chat room, so welcome to the chat room, as well as to those that aren't in the chat room, and that are just kind of watching. Welcome as well to an episode of WeChat. It's always a pleasure, and this is the opportunity for you to ask us any questions that you may have. You can do so by sending us an email at finalcontrol@wildearth.tv, or you can always just log on to the chat room and ask us. And yeah, if you're in the chat room, one of the things that makes it a little bit easier, as you can see, that it's sometimes hard to read the names. If you have a specific question for one of the people here chatting at Wild Earth, just kind of state who the question is for, and then maybe if you want your name mentioned, put it up, just type it in afterwards. And it looks like Pete got it up and running, so we're going to switch over.
Yeah, it's like with any tape recorder, it helps if you press play. I forgot that. So now you should see a little screen coming up. Yep, there's the hyena. There's no sound with the recording. That's still something we're figuring out. Because we're using actually a security type closed circuit TV cameras there, it also sends, it's a bit technical, it sends a time code with the video signal. And the recording software actually reads that time code as a sound, so you get a very annoying sound with it. So, because of that, I'm just going to play you the video without the sound, but as you can see, a hyena pop-up was quite a nice sighting earlier. The vultures are still in the background there, it was just after that. So that's why I didn't want to interrupt the drive again. And both of them must have been at the buffalo carcass, because otherwise it would be too much of a coincidence. Peter mentioned on the drive that he saw the hyena just very close to the beginning of the drive. It's probably the same one. And when he saw it, it was running away from the direction of where the buffalo carcass was. So it's not just the lions that, after eating the buffalo, it's also the vultures and the hyena that came to drink after that. And pretty soon, actually, was quite surprised that it did that. It's probably going to move off to the right. Let me actually just speed it up. That's another nice thing of this. I can just quickly go fast. Up. There it is again. And then it had a bath, which is we've seen it them do that before, but always when it was hot and later in the day. I personally, at least, have not seen them doing that this early in the morning. So actually, I found that quite interesting. Yep, there it goes. Okay, let me quickly also show another one. Now you can see my whole computer screen. I think it was this one. I think this actually was during the break, but some people might not have seen the drive this morning. We had a couple of hooded vultures at the waterhole. Right here, and then some impala came, and there was almost like a bit of a standoff, or trying to figure out, is it safe to walk between the vultures, and I think so. The impala looked a bit nervous, but in the end they decided to just march through slowly. Let me just make it a little bit bigger for you. That one is a bit nervous. Just give us a wide berth. As you can see, they aim their path exactly halfway between the vultures, so they keep maximum distance between them and the vultures. But still, of course, it's going to be a hot day, and the impalas must know that, so they're definitely not going to miss out on getting a drink. We just fast forward a little bit. And actually, this feature this in this media player is actually sometimes it's nice to watch something a little bit quicker because you actually get a much better idea about the dynamics or the movements of things like that, or the flow of things. But yeah, the impalas are moving around here. One other thing in that respect actually reminds me. I think I quickly looked it up. What I found quite interesting, one of the first times I was experimenting with this, during the night, a common duiker arrived. And actually also, I was just scanning through it and actually playing it a little bit faster than normal. And what I found interesting, what you could clearly see on that, I'm just going to play it like that now, is how cautious and circumspect animals are when they approach a waterhole.